when I threw, I made a ball change in the last ball of the eighth game because I knew I was locked into a 220 ball reaction, but I needed 240. Yeah. I wasn't going to be able to. So I made a ball change in a four and a half board move with my feet, the ball change, and it looked so good. It's just like, well, I'm either going to shoot 190 or I'm going to shoot 280. It's going to be it.
Yeah.
But I at least I'm going to give myself a chance. If this is my last hurrah at this tournament, I want to, I'm not going to hold it. Not going to hold back. Not going to play it safe. And I generally play it safe. I'm a very conservative player. So I went like strike week 7, and I had like a 4-5 bagger working. So I'm in the 230s, up in the 8th, and I remember this vividly. In 2013, a lady jumped me when I was chasing down the singles lead, and I big forward, and I missed winning singles by 8 pins. And I said, it's never going to happen to me ever again. Ever. It's not going to happen. And I mean, I'm coming down to this. I mean, this is happening. This is, cameras are out.
Everyone around knows.
Everybody knows. Well, the people to my left were like novice, regular classified division folks, and nothing against them. They just, it was like their first year bowling the tournament.
Yeah.
They didn't know. They didn't know what was going on. And so they weren't. I was waiting for like 2 lanes. I wanted 2 lanes, and I was going to wait till I got 2 lanes. I stepped off that shot probably 3-4 times. That frame took like 4-5 minutes. And when I finally did throw the shot, it was mediocre, but I got a good mixer out of it. And then I knew it was going to happen after that.
Yeah.
I got
away
with that one.
Yep. Yep.
And then I just knew. Yep. I was in the 240s, and I said, I'm just going to take it off the sheet.
Wonderful feeling.
It is. And that was the most rewarding one. There was no honor counts. There was no 800s. There was no anything. It was just absolute phenomenal, great bowling when not a lefty was seen in the top, like, 40 for all events.
Yeah. I mean, I bowled that year, and they were brutal when – you could break them down how you wanted to. I can't imagine bowling the fresh pretty much the whole time, you know. Yeah.
So that was it. Like when I won that tournament, that was really it for me. And I don't know if it had like a counter effect as, okay, I made it. I'm gonna get into the National Hall of Fame, or knock on wood, I hope I've accredited or accumulated enough.
Yeah.
To get
sure.
in. I don't know if that hurt my competitive desire going forward. But I mean, I remember I think I bowled you in a tournament.
11th frame.
Yeah, that 11th frame.
Yeah.
And so every now and then my desire comes back.
I was going to say, you were really fired up, man. You definitely didn't hold back in that match.
Yeah.
You had 260 against me or something.
Yeah,
like that.
And I was dead in the 5th frame. I mean, I went like wash out. Spare, strike, and you had like the front 5 or 6.
Yeah, I almost think it was 250 to 240 or something.
Yeah,
like that.
I tell you what, man, you throw the ball so good. I was just like, man, I need to get a few breaks to beat somebody this good.
Oh, whatever.
No, man, I wouldn't go that far.
These are mind games he's playing with. Future down.
I'm not buying it.
He knew in that match, he's like, this guy's dead in the water. He doesn't stand a chance.
But, man, it was a good year because I won the Peterson that year, too. And I remember that vividly because I was the only the second left-hander in like 100 and some odd years to win that tournament. There's a guy named Lee Snow out of Detroit that won it. But me and him are the only left-handers to ever win a tournament.
That's cool. Amazing.
So that was pretty cool. It was a good year. And, you know, USBC, it's such a different, I guess it's just a different environment.
It is a different environment, yeah.
You're with your team, right?
Yeah.
You know, and everybody on that pair believes in you and wants to see you bowl well. When I feel like I come out here, I just feel like I'm being judged and analyzed, and I feel that nobody feels I deserve to win.
Well, there's so much confidence walking around here. It's like it's maybe not egotistical, maybe there is, and cockiness and whatever. And some of it's confused, some of it's not. But there's very strong-minded people around here, and that's why they're the best in the world. And
yeah,
sometimes it can be intimidating. It really can.
Yeah.
And I think everyone kind of feels like that at some point in time in their career when they're bowling out here. Sometimes it's tough. Sometimes it's rough. And sometimes the hardest part isn't the bowling part. It's the believing part.
Yeah.
And the people that you're surrounded by are all these brilliant, world-class people. And it's very easy to not think of yourself as part of that group. So definitely understand where you're coming from there.
Yeah.